Now when the sun come up, I'll be there to say what up in the morning. Brush my teeth, find that clip I've been looking for since last night.
Hi, I'm Shelby.
Christina Garcia.
I'm Camry.
I'm Mecca Achin.
My name is Emil Greco.
Name is Jennifer.
I am Vitigana Zaragoza.
My name is Mr. McCain.
Hi, I'm Nancy Castro.
Bullying is something that occurs a lot, I guess, in when you're in elementary school and stuff, and that's what happened to me pretty much. I had a lot of people who said they were my friends, but they really weren't. They would slap me and make fun of me, and I guess I kind of just stayed with them because I didn't really have anybody else.
I guess you could say I was cyberbullied off of Facebook because girls would talk a lot about, like, what I did with my life.
When I was in elementary, like, I was bullied, and because I didn't look the same as everybody else, like, people were making fun of me, and they pushed me, and they tell lies on me.
I was bullied throughout middle school and elementary school because of my ethnicity and how I look in my eyes. When I was real little, about fifth grade, there was this real bigger kid. I was in a school where they had like kindergarten through, I think it was like eighth. So one of the bigger kids came around and started pushing over some of my friends, and I tried to stand up, but I got pushed around too, and it just kind of continued for a little while.
I used to be bullied as a little kid for the clothes I wore because my parents weren't like the upper class. So I always used to get bullied and get teased on for wearing like little crummy pants and always wearing jackets. But
a family member has been affected by bullying. When she was affected by bullying, she was like 4 or 5, and she was always bullied about her weight. So now every time she comes home and say, "Oh, don't eat that chocolate," she's like, "Why, you can't eat that?" And she gets all emotional.
In high school, my sister and I ended up at the same school. I have a sister who's developmentally disabled. She probably has the mental capacity of probably a 2-year-old, maybe. People tend to call people like that, the non-political term is mentally retarded. So I have a sister who was at the same school as me. We're in the same school, and I just remember guys teasing, you know, the students in those special day classes, and them not knowing that, you know, one of those students with my sister.
I was a cheerleader, and there was a group of kids that really would harass me and make fun of me, call me stuck up, and that people that really didn't know me or who I was.
Now it affects me because I see other people go through that, and I know it's not really fair. There's like cyberbullying and that stuff, you know, people hide behind screens, and it like really affects others, and people commit suicide, and they just don't know how to deal with it. They have no way to, like, they have no out.
I didn't let it bring me down.
It's on me, so that's definitely affecting me. Like, I don't like talking to people that much. I'm very shy and like antisocial.
I felt terrible, actually. Then, like, I was like, you know what, I'm cooler than them, and so, yeah. And then I got, like, friends that, like, actually accept me for who I am, like, don't make fun of me, like, here and there, like some other kids did.
Well, it, you know, it made me feel kind of small, because I couldn't really do anything, and I felt bad.
It made me feel down inside, like, they were picking on me as a little kid, and no one really understood what money was back then.
Oh, she's only 9, so now she's already thinking, is this going to make me fat, or do I look ugly? Am I not going to have friends? So she thinks nobody's going to like her just because of her weight.
At some point, something's probably going to happen if, you know, one of them end up messing with my sister. I'm more of a person that don't like people to be bullied, and when I see signs of bullying, I'm the first person to step in. Between the bully and the person that's being bullied.
It was very hurtful because I didn't consider myself that kind of a person. I really wanted to be friends with all people.
I was able to find better friends. So
I know there's people out there who let it get to them, and it obviously goes to the extreme, but you can't let it get to you like that. You have to be confident in yourself and in yourself.
It's a work in progress, so I'm definitely working on it. I'm like a lot more outgoing than I was. Like I have a lot more friends.
Grow like a teacher, tell your parents. Just like try to do anything you can to like make it stop, because no one deserves to be bullied.
I eventually went to a teacher and got it sorted out.
I mean, walk away, you're your own person, and they can't really do anything about it.
We were there for her, and then, so now she doesn't really care what people say about her anymore. She just ignores it and walks away, so it doesn't really care anymore.
I felt that it was my responsibility for people who didn't have a voice, and I felt like my sister didn't have a voice because she couldn't, you know, say what she felt, you know, and she didn't have the ability to do that. So I felt like it was my responsibility to speak for her, and I did.
And my parents always taught me that, you know, fighting isn't going to really solve it. It's that you need to use your brain to solve those issues, that you need to use communication and try to talk things out. It's not always possible to talk to somebody who is bullying you. They may not want to hear what you have to say, but at the very least, just to kind of walk away and say, you know, I don't have a problem with you.